Hi, this is Gregor from baseball.com and today I have the pleasure to show you the Beach Combo 5-string bass from Hutchins Guitars. This brand is based in the UK, mainly producing here in Germany, but this is actually from a rather affordable series made in Asia. And yeah, it's a funky, colorful little bass, so let's check it out. Beach Combo is, as I mentioned, a rather affordable bass from Hutchins Guitars, and there are a couple of more models in this range, and they're all something in the 600-700 euro range, somewhere around that. And they look really cool. They also make this one and that one. The Beach Combo 5-string is a passive bass with a bunch of interesting sound options. I would say the basic sound is very similar to a 60s kind of jazz bass, but you have these two little treble cut switches here, one for every pickup, and if you use those, this bass will sound like a warm vintage bass that has no treble frequencies at all. Interesting. If you want to hear what it sounds like, you will actually need a set of headphones or decent speakers now, so go grab some, come back, and let's go. Beach Combo has, as you can see here, a bolt-on design, comes with a basswood body, and this particular one with this cool dark blue metallic finish. Basswood is a wood that's often used by companies as a substitute for alder because it's a little bit more affordable and sounds actually very similar to alder, and I would say probably 90% of players wouldn't even be able to tell these two woods apart, so that's cool. The neck is made from one piece of maple, has a satin finish and a very slim profile, so if you can handle 5-string necks, you will be able to handle this one. It feels great and plays like butter. On the front we have 20 frets and a blackwood fingerboard, and there is it again. A couple of weeks ago we reviewed a Harley Benton bass and they also claimed to use a blackwood fingerboard, and in this video I said blackwood doesn't even exist. What is this supposed to be? And I don't know, I hope this is not just a new way of companies of getting around these size regulations that kind of restricted the use of rosewood, because this actually plays and looks and sounds like rosewood, so I hope this is not just a way of getting around these regulations, just naming it different. I don't know. However, we have a 34-inch scale and we have a 48mm width at the nut. The pickups are two single coils and they are placed in these classical 60s jazz bass positions. They come with these closed covers, which of course doesn't look very traditional, but it's a functional thing, because especially if you like a low string action, you don't have to be afraid that the strings will hit the pole pieces and create these terrible loud noises. The controls is also rather classical. We have two volume controls, one tone, and up here we have one mute switch that mutes the bass completely, and these two treble cut switches that we already talked about. The hardware isn't like super fancy, so there's no Hipshot or Goto or whatever brand name dropping here, but don't worry about it. It actually seems very solid and nothing that I would be concerned about using even on a long tour or whatever. It seems very well made. For the A and the D string, we even have a string retainer that helps them to get enough tension on the bone nut. The string spacing at the nut is 10mm and at the bridge we have 90mm, which is like the standard, I would say, and this helps you to get the space in your hand, play it and feel like home and very familiar right away, especially also with this very slim neck. This is a bass that you just play it and it feels like a bass that you've already played many times before, which is always good. The bridge itself is a 2D design, that means you can adjust the intonation and the string height. Thank you. say this bass is mainly for people who like traditional jazz bass sounds but don't like the boring traditional look of a Fender jazz bass or any other jazz bass kind of bass. So if you like cool designs but you like classical tones, this is your bass. And even with these two little switches here, you can realize some sounds that you won't get out of any other bass, which is of course always cool to have. What I very much appreciate about this bass is the B string. On this bass in particular, the B string is super fat, sounds just perfect. And yeah, I think for the money that this bass costs, I think it's very well made. It sounds great. There's nothing I could really criticize here. Even the use of bass wood, which some consider as a cheap wood, this bass just sounds good. And if you like it, what it looks like, just go with it. I think you can order it from Hutchins Guitars directly, but I'm sure they also have a range of dealers around the world. So if you're interested, check them out on the website. If you have any questions, please leave them in the video description. And I guess that's it for today. See you next time. Bye.